Cinnamon Cooney, your art Sherpa, and I've got a fabulous, exciting Pinterfix project today. These fabulous lovebirds on a branch on denim canvas. That's right, just as you've seen in Mate Market, that denim canvas is something you can do with it. So grab your brushes, grab your canvases, grab one of these denim things. Don't have denim? It's okay. I have an Instructables just for that. Come back and meet me at this easel right now. We're gonna do this crazy set of birds. Come on. Okay. The intro. Welcome to the Pinterfix. This fantastic project is incredibly easy, and you can do it with materials you can find easily, or if you need to make your own denim canvas because you can't find any, go of course to Instructables. Where are they? In the link, the links. You go to Instructables, and I've got a step-by-step on how to make a regular canvas look like denim. So even if you can't find one of these fabulous canvases, or you don't feel like going and stretching some denim over some stretcher bars and all of that jazz, which you could do, but and just so the back with clear gesso, I don't know why you do it, but you could do it. Basically, you would just be going to Michael's, to the Make Market, and grabbing the denim canvases they had, or painting your canvas a solid color to do this project. Why am I doing a Pinterfix? Well, guys, I don't know about you, but I love me some Pinterest. Do you love you some Pinterest? I love me some Pinterest! I get in on there, and I'm so excited, and I want to make that dinner, and I want to make that fabulous, incredible drink with the flowers all frozen in the ice cube. Oh, I want to do that, and I get really excited, but then I also see stuff. I see stuff that makes me just crazy as an artist. Pinterest tip number one, Elmer's glue is not the most powerful art material in the world, okay? It can't do all that stuff. You guys keep thinking that it, I mean, it's like viral out there what people think that Elmer's glue can do. And I'm always seeing stuff I got real inspired by. And I'm going to tell you right now who it is. Do you guys know who Threadbanger is? I'm not collaborating. They don't know who I am. They have like a million subscribers. They have no earthly idea about me or my little weird end of YouTube. But I know about them. And I watch them all the time. If you don't know about Threadbanger, to put them in context, it's a little bit like Daria met Butthead and they got married. It's kind of what that actually is like. I'm really into it because I grew up on those cartoons. Think of them as the Kate and Will of YouTube. That's right, they're YouTube royalty. Trigger warning, a lot of cussing, some blood, some craziness. If you can't handle those things, you want to enjoy the channel. But if you like funny Pinter tests, that's the place to go. I love watching that. But again, I'm always like, Mod Podge doesn't do that, guys. There's no way this pin will work because Mod Podge can't do that. So that's where Pinterfix came from. You guys start making some suggestions to me. And the big one that I got from you was denim. This denim, that denim, the denim pins, right? And so I was like, oh, denim canvases. What should we do with that? So I went to the Michaels, like you do. And I huffed and huffed around Michaels. And guess where the denim is not? It is not in the art supplies where you think it is. And so for a while there, I thought you guys were crazy. Just crazy people telling me that you had denim canvases you wanted me to do something with. But then having to get something else in Michaels, I walked by that Make Market thing they have. And what do you know? That's where all the burlap and linen and denim was. And they have all kinds of denim products there. And denim canvases in all sizes. I don't know if it's seasonal. It might be seasonal, which is why I created a how to make this look on Instructables so you don't have to worry about it. I also included how to foil some of this up if you want to get really fancy. So there I am researching Pinterest, and you know what I discovered? There's no good pins on denim on Pinterest. You can do this starburst if you feel like getting your sewing machine out and anyways, this is some artist work. This is not easy. I've done some quilting. I can tell you, having done quilting, piecing, like finding the 20 different shades of denim jeans and then cutting out your little strips and separating them into shades and stuff. This is not a DIY glue project. I can tell you that for sure. And then, of course, there's the I can paint with denim. Bam! No. No. You're not doing this. That's crazy. You can't do it with paint. You're not going to be doing it with denim. And then there's like some really crazy denim projects. Boom. And then, of course, weird denim couture. So I'm like, great. So the Pinter fix for this one is I've got to make a project for us that does not suck on denim, because you don't want to do this daisy or this string art. Yeah, remember these two? This is what they made, all these canvases, and then they said, and you could do some string art. Not a good job. No. But I do think denim is awesome, and here's what it's going to basically look like. It's these things. This is what it is. It's this little make market label tells you where it is in the store. No one in the store is going to know where it is if you ask them. That's been my experience. I'm using a 16 by 20. I used my 40% off coupon, and it was really reasonable. If you absolutely don't want to draw at all, I found this denim stretched on board and this cherry blossom stencil. So you could still get the project and not draw a thing. My point is, don't let Pinterest just be an inspiration board. Don't let it just be your dreams and fairyland. Let's do some of these things. Let's do some of these projects. At the end of this, I'm going to put up a card of some possible projects that I think you might like to see me do. You tell me in the comments which one it is, and my next Pinterest fix, I will do that. All right, so I'm going to throw this over here. I didn't do that. That didn't happen. Let's open up our canvas, all right? So beyond this, what are you going to need for this project? Well, apparently indestructible. Okay, guys, this is in like some sort of super plastic. What? You know what? I'm an artist and I have tools, so that's fine. This isn't some sort of super plastic. That's my palette knives. My nails couldn't do it. I had to get palette knives. Okay, they're really about protecting your denim canvas. Why is this denim canvas special? Huh? Why is it special? It's got clear gesso on the back. That's what it is. You clear gesso something on the back or on the front, you can probably paint it. You can't see the clear gesso. You know why? Because it's clear. That's why. All right. And this is especially one of those projects where I think it would be perfectly acceptable to use the folk art acrylic paints with the gold caps, especially acceptable to use that. So that's all that is. This is going to be super easy. And of course, I'm showcasing my wet palette, which is in this video, if you want to go learn how to do that. This just keeps your paint from drying out. You guys are always like, my paint dries out. This does that, and how to make that is on that other video. It's just craziness today. Like my grumpy cat hat. So YouTube-tacular. All right, I've got yellow ochre, titanium white, and black. Again, I think the folk art paint is perfectly fine. I'm going to be using assorted acrylic brushes. Just any reasonable acrylic brush will do this. And I'm going to list those. Boom, 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 boom. Where they always are. In that about section. Guys, click the more button on about. You'll see like two sentences. There's more. There's always more. I give you more. And it's down there. Let's just do this project. So in the suggestions, I've also been hearing a lot about cherry blossoms, cherry blossoms, cherry blossoms. You'll see some other project options that you can do in Instructables, but we're going to work on a cherry blossom branch today. And to do that, I'm going to want a half inch bright. Half inch bright is going to do most of this for me. And to do the moon, I'm going to want a 1 inch filbert, right? And I probably will want a small detail, like at least a 1/4 inch bright or small detail brush, like a small round detail, like this for this. So I'm thinking that's what my brushes are going to be. So I'm going to put those here to put them aside. And the first thing I'm going to want to do is I'm going to kind of want to put my little moon reflection in. I'm going to put it over here to this far side because I want my cherry blossoms to really show against the deep blue. And remember, you can do this just on a regular, just paint the canvas any color you like and it will work. And I'm going to not put my brush in coffee. Come over here. I've got my brush a little bit wet. I'm going to get a little bit of white and a little bit of gold. And I'm going to come right here in this little corner here, which is almost a hand down and a hand over. Hand down, hand over. And I'm going to just start this sort of like little round thing. If you've done the Vincent van Gogh flower thing with me, you're like, oh, wait. Oh, wait. I know what it is. That's right. You know what it is. You can do it. You can do it at this juncture. You can do it. Actually, it's really funny. Like, even though I live in Houston, I've lived here decades. And I do sometimes have a bit of a country accent. It mostly comes out on fur, which my husband points out to me all the time. It mostly only comes out if I'm really angry. So it's like a really rundown version of the Hulk. Don't make me angry or you'll hear my country come out. But I'm not today. I'm not remotely angry today. I'm pretty happy. I'm doing curved light brush strokes. The trick to this is the denim is going to want a drier paint. It's going to skip over the denim. Okay. 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 There's a South Park reference. So Beavis and Butthead today. We've South Park. Threadbanger, not family friendly at all. It's the Game of Thrones of craft shows. That's what it is. It's the Game of Thrones of craft shows. That is exactly what it is. Exactly. Now go watch it and come back and tell me if it is not the Game of Thrones of craft shows. And if you're not like, they are the king of YouTube. What is going on? I didn't even know. See, because you wouldn't even know. You wouldn't know without me because we're in our weird little corner of YouTube. Have you guys been excited about this project? It's a really fun couple of birds that we're going to do. So I'm kind of letting this weight be here and I'm coming out here. And I'm going to leave this out here like this because I just want this to say, there's reflection. There's a moon in the sky. Brush is going to go in the water, not the coffee. My delicious beverage today is a lovely cup of coffee. But no sugar. Healthy life choices. I'm going to get that half inch angle brush that I mentioned. I'm going to get it a little wet. And I'm going to come load it up with some black paint. Cherry blossoms are different than other branches we've done because they're like all crickety and rickety and they kind of go around like that. Got to get back into our Jackie Chan soul. Got to get back into our Jackie Chan junkie monkey. We're going to meander and wander and be bizarre around the canvas. Okay, so hang in with me here. I'm going to start this sucker about four fingers up or hand. It's like a hand up. And that's where my branch is going to start. You've done this with me a couple times. You're like, boy, she likes to start a branch there. Yeah, yeah, I do. Makes me happy. It's just the easiest, happiest place to start a branch for me. And I'm going to go down and then, oh no, I'm cricketing up. What is that? Down. And then cricketing up because cherry blossoms are some crookedy, crickety, weird little things. And then as I crest up here, I'm going to take this down. And that's where it goes. See that weird little, it's just a jaggedy thing. Again, they're stencils. If this is like, oh, that doesn't look fun to me at all. They're stencils. I've got a simpler step-by-step tree. Not as complicated as this tree. On Instructables, I always give you guys those like bailout options. So I'm going to come up about an inch and a half up here, make another mark. And I'm going to sort of parallelly follow along. But you know what? I'm going to let this be not as perfect. A lot more crookedier than what I usually do. Okay? How is this craft paint working? Just fine. Didn't have good coverage right there, but it's just fine. Could you use your good acrylic paints if you purchase them? Yes, of course you could. You can always use them. Golden will do this. They don't want to do this. They don't want to be painting this, but they absolutely can, and you don't let anything hold you back. You don't let anything hold you back. And you're going to just paint in this branch. Come on. Come in with me here and paint this in. Paint it in, paint it in. So what you're going to notice about the denim, if you're painting a denim canvas, is that it's very absorbent, right? And you're like, you moved your coffee. I did move my coffee. Don't worry about that. Just add a little water if you need to when you're covering the canvas. It doesn't need to be perfect, by the way. This is going to be so impressive to your friends when they come over to the house, because they've got these in all sizes. They have itty bitty mini canvases and all the way up to some pretty big ones. This may be a seasonal item, so run out and grab them just in case it is. And then they'll be like, oh, everybody likes denim. And I'll be like, I caused that love of denim. But hey, I want these companies to make weird products like this for us. I kind of am cricketing that up a bit. Did you see that? I want this to be very, like, a broken, messed up, crazy little bit of a branch. And we're building this base for these little birds to sit on, because that's where they landed. They're in love, these little birds. But it doesn't have to be birds, guys. There's a lot of silhouette artists out there. Silver Creek Studios, Studio Silver Creek, has a ton of the best silhouette painting projects. You could do any of them on a denim canvas. It would completely work. You go by there, you see what Leanne's got going on. It is amazing. She's got all kinds of cool stuff happening. Lots of, she makes her own mediums, which is really cool, and she shares those recipes, which I was super impressed with, because I do not make my own spiritual medium. I just buy it. You know, I was feeling like, man, maybe I'm not, like, trying, like, hard enough here. Oh no, I'm traveling down. All right, so we've got this crookedy branch, and I'm gonna get these little birds in. It's a silhouette painting. Don't freak out about it, guys. It's a silhouette painting. Who knows what it is in silhouettes? You know, I did the deer to y'all, and y'all like, some of you are like, I love the deer, and some of you are like, I'm not, no deer at my window. No deer at my window. I'm talking about this video here. It was also a silhouette, which if you didn't paint in the sunset, if you just painted the deer in the tree, would also work. Any silhouette painting will work. Go check out some silhouette paintings. I'm going to make a little circle. That's going to be the base of my bird. Sitting right here. Right here. I feel like right here. This is where that's going to be. That's how I always start this. This is an ellipse. This is an ellipse. Again, guess what they have? They have bird stencils. If you're like, I don't draw circles, that's not my thing. Don't let drawing be the yes I can paint, no I can paint of your life. Drawing is just an art skill. It is not the only art skill. Right? It's not. It's not how we, you know, if we can draw well, then we're good artists. I know it seems like that, but it really isn't. There are many great artists that are not particularly good draftsmen. And it's okay. All right? It's okay. Don't let that be whether or not you go on Pinterest and say, I'm going to try that crazy project. But not with Elmer's glue, because Elmer's glue does not do that. I'm going to include one that I know what it actually was. You guys vote on it. In cart. Go by there. There'll be something silly. And vote on what little pin thing you want me to do next. I'll have the three suggestions of what I'm thinking I want to do. Of ones that I know bug me to death. Because I know that they're not true. They're not true. And we'll do something like that. And we'll stop making Pinterest. See, I'm coming down here on my tail. And my tail, I'm just coming down, drag it, drop. Drag it and drop it. Drag it and drop it. All right, guys, that's all it is. And I let it feather out here. I'm not mental about that. There's also about a million ways to do two little birds on a branch. Don't like my two little birds. Find other birds you like. Don't let anything hold you back from your creative destiny. So I'm going to come up here and I'm going to make a little circle. It's going to be his head. And I'm going to come right here. I'm going to make a little wing shape. That's what this is. The hump. And you may not like the hump. You might be like, why does that bird have a hump? And I'm going to say to you, it's not a hump. It's his little wing shape. It's his little body wing shape. I'm going to make a little chin right there. Little curve. It's a little upward, like a little frown. Okay, and it's going to be his little beak. And then I'm going to come in with a little smile and join it into the head. Creates that little triangle there. That's all that is. We don't stress on that. We don't worry about that. You know? Alright, see? So, little bird silhouette. He needs a friend. He needs somebody to love. So, I'm going to make another little circle here. Make another little oval. Making an oval. Ovaling it up. This is not ice skating, though. We don't have to be that precise. Do y'all watch ice skating? When I grew up with my mom watching a lot of ice skating, she's really brutal on ice skaters. Like, Mama Ginger. Oh my goodness, she's like really brutal on the ice skaters. Like, her commentary on costumes is rough. Just, I'm just saying, you wouldn't want to have her be in charge of the news station that was reviewing ice skaters, because it would be like, it'd be pretty intense. They go home crying. She has some opinions on where you should put a sequin and should not put a sequin. So she's super friendly on her art channel, for sure. I don't know where that tangent came from. But not on ice skaters. It's just, you know what? It's just the truth. It's just the truth. She's rough on ice skaters. She's just rough on ice skaters. Though she did call that whole Nancy Kerrigan thing back in the day. Totally called that whole scenario. Like, she knew what had happened. Knew what had happened. And was all about it. Which I'm like, how did you predict that? She did. Because she's psychic about ice skating. Just psychic about it. She's got a little live classes. You can ask her a question about it on her next little live class. She does those, I think, on Wednesdays. Check it out on her channel. Alright, so we want this bird to be looking at this bird this way. So I'm going to give it a little circle for a head. Wow, this is a lot like just building snowmen. Just little circles. Little circles. And, you know, if you find that your paint is suddenly gray, that's just because it wasn't dry. And that's fine. It'll dry. You just paint it more black if you want to. You're just trying to tell the story. Why do I do the birds before I do the whole branch? That's because I want branches to be like a bunch of different places, and I sort of need to know where their bodies are. So when I fill that in, that works. Thank you for letting me know when the whole thumbnail fiasco happened and then we had found out we were missing the fourth camera footage on foiling the birds. Thank you for letting me know that so many of you were not into the foiled birds. Though, seriously, foiled birds were awesome. That project is on Instructables too, just in case you wanted to foil them. Because I thought the foiling looked amazing. Amazing when they were foiled, my opinion. But it's okay, it's your channel, so it's alright. I mean, like, I'm hearing stuff, but... Alright, little beak going back this way. The little beak is back this direction. And I think I'm going to do a little wing shape. Oh, I may have gotten a little crazy with my wing shape. Maybe you do a less excited wing shape than I did. I'll show you how to fix that if you get too excited on the wing shape. As long as it's over the moon, you can actually fix some of that if you want. Over the denim, then you got to be like a tattoo artist. You got to be like super creative. See, I'm just coming down with these like little strokes and they're like lighter there. That's how I always get that light little finish, is that I just lighten my pressure. Strong pressure, light pressure. That's all it is. Look, that's just in. That's just in. Alright, so let's say you boo-boo the wing. okay? You have boo-booed the wing. Get you a brush. Get you a little white and some gold paint that you probably got left over. Okay? Just shave it where the moon is. You can totally do that, and it will look okay. Just blend it in. A lot of times in acrylic paint, as long as the paint is dry, you've got some total forgiveness for what you can do. And I recommend using it where you can. So wherever you need that second coat of paint to get that nice high black look you might be looking for, go for it. This is not as textural as, say, the burlap that we painted on. Right? Not as textural, but still a very, very good texture to that. See? Two birds and a moon. Birds! Birds, 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 birds. So let's get the rest of this rickety cool, absolutely awesome cherry blossom branch in. I'm still going to use my little half inch here. Actually, I might switch to almost a quarter inch, because this is heftier than I might like, and I want a sharper edge. So I'm going to switch to, or I guess I could switch to this, but I'm going to switch to this one. See, these would all be in the comments. I always put all the sizes in the comments, just in case one of these moments happens in a lesson, and they will. They will happen. So read the stuff down there. Links and comments and information about hats and all kinds of upcoming things. Right? All kinds of upcoming things. Hashtag love summer art. Hashtag love summer art. July 17th of 2015, but it will be up forever. So I guess it always applies once it's up. All right. So I'm going to take this little branch up here and I'm going to do that same little thing. Look at me meander my crookedy, crookedy little self. It's an exercise in this, and this is where people just really have a little trouble with the cherry blossoms, is because they have so much tree emotion. You don't think you have tree emotion, but you do. You have a lot of tree feelings. Little sunsets, and lying in the grass, and climbing trees, and looking at trees, and all the kinds of trees you know. Trust me, you have a lot of internal tree stuff. It's messing with you. You don't know it's messing with you, but it is. All right, I'm going to put a little weird downward branch right here. And it's going to go up, down. It does that weirdness because I want it to. It's going to do what I say because I'm in charge of the branch. Right? There. There's a little weird little branch. Have some fun making weird little branches. I'm going to cross one over here. Coming down. It's going to cross. Because they do. Alright. And then I feel like I need another one kind of working it up here. So I'm going to start here. Come up. Look at that. Yeah. I did that. I own it. And again, you didn't feel like doing all this. You could just stencil this whole thing out. But I'm saying, let's paint it in. Let's be brave. Let's not worry about stuff. Let's enjoy ourselves. So going down here. Now I might do something crazy like cross in front of my tails. Did you see how I did that? Oh, it implies a tree of three dimensions that these birds are perched in. It's complicated art stuff we did there, but we did it like we don't care. We don't care. We can do it. You can do it. You've got your delicious beverage. You're up for this. Once you were up for the magic mushroom, you were up for all of it. Was that a fun lesson or what? I think it was. I'm excited to see what you guys are about on the next Pinterfix, because I've got some good suggestions that I know from what you did on Pinterest you're kind of interested in. I've got some. Guess what we won't be using? Elmer's glue. Mm-mm. Doesn't do that. I have some really strong feelings about the limitations of Elmer's glue, which is a fantastic product and is really good for making galaxy slime. Used it for that. That totally works. You can totally make any kind of slime
with Elmer's.
That's true. It's true. Even Rob thinks it's true over on Threadbanger. Even Rob says so.
All right, I'm going to come down here.
I'm doubtful if the blood's real, though. They don't know who I am, so I can say that. I'm doubtful. I feel like I'm not really sure if the blood's real. I'd love your opinion. Go check it out. Tell me if you think it is. So see how I've created those things there? I'm going to kind of think about this brush, this tree right here. Come wickety up. So what's my rule about tree branches, right? They're fatter, and then they get skinnier as they get older, unlike the rest of us. They get skinnier as they get older, right? Woohoo! Crazy, crazy. Alright. I'm thinking about that this week. Wednesday, the 1st of July. I don't know when this will go up. Probably Saturday. But Wednesday, the 1st of July is my birthday. And it's such a weird birthday. I don't know what I think about this birthday. I don't know what I think. I don't know what I feel. I'm kind of just really happy to be here. I love being with my family. I love I get to do this crazy YouTube thing with you guys. So I'm kind of just... See how I sometimes let these little brush strokes kind of imply out? That's the little bitty twiggly bits that break off on cherry blossoms. We're almost done. Now, let's fill out our tree branch so that we can hang some flowers on it. So I'm going to come here, and I'm going to come over to the left. Yeah. You know, you can practice a stroke on a scratch piece of paper. You can be like, oh, no, I want to do that. And just do that on a scratch piece of paper. It's just totally allowed. Is the up-close cam helping? Is it helping? I think I need a... Yeah, there we go. Sometimes you'll see that, like, get back. And what do we got to do? We back up. And we look for what is bugging us. What's bugging us? You know, that's what was bugging me. Look for those little holes. Find your little holes. Those of you that have found Instructables with me, how are you liking that crazy site? Is that not, like, amazing? I think it's amazing. So many weird little awesome tidbits and insights and projects and things. Not just the wonderful Sherpa stuff that you have, but also just like a lot for you to do. A lot of interesting stuff for you to do for the home, for your life. A lot of life hacks. Love life hacks. Grizzly Adams, early life hacker. Didn't even know it. Didn't even know it, did he? Didn't even know it. Alright. I feel good about that. I feel real good about that. So I'm going to get my... It's like a quarter inch bright for this part. The cherry blossoms, here's some stuff to know. If you're going to show them as having 5 petals or 3 petals. Like, if the flower were at half view, it would have 3 petals, but if it was straight on view, it would have 5. There's a lot of ways to put in cherry blossoms. They're all pretty good. You can see a lot of, like, Pinterest tips on, like, this kind of cherry blossom or that kind of cherry blossom. I like the more open one, where you just do a little dab of yellow in the center, because it lets your eye finish it. And you know me, I like things that let your eye finish it. I'm going to get a little water, get a little paint. Alright, come over here to my white paint, and I'm going to start putting blossoms, and I'm going to go like this. I'm going to do a little curved stroke and a little curved stroke, right? And I'm going to do a little outward stroke and a little outward stroke and then a little base stroke, and that's one kind of cherry blossom. The other kind that you might have is the 1, 2, 3. And these will be bigger and smaller depending on where you put them. And then another kind of cherry blossom shape that you might have
is the five petals straight on. So that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, the trick to something like this is some of your blossoms should be bigger than others. I will even put them where they're not attached to a branch. I'm gonna put some here. Look at that. That one's there. Little tiny one here. You can rotate the canvas if you need a better angle. I'm gonna do another one of big ones. I really like those. I like those too. It's just some different little cherry blossom shapes. It's implying the different tip. How much is the petal facing you, right? It's really facing you. You'll see all five. But if it's not, you would see like maybe just three. And don't be afraid to put them places. Like I'll just put like a free flowing petal, because remember, they fly off the trees. They fly off the trees. They only do this awesome bloom for like a minute. This is very short. This is like a azaleas in Houston. It's not a long deal, man. And if there's rain, forget about it. It's over. So you got like a second to appreciate you some cherry blossoms. But this cherry blossom that you're making yourself, you may appreciate it for all time on denim. And people will be like, is that painting on denim? You'll be like, it is. Isn't it fabulous? And they'll be like, yes, I'm so impressed. And you'll be like, yeah, it's my newest piece. I'm so awesome. I will sometimes still put them over here, even though the white doesn't show up as much over that, just because I feel like it's a subtle thing that makes a difference. It's an opinion that I have. See, I'm just pushing those little brush strokes down. I'm being so very, like, not wound up about this thing. All right, I'm going to go like this because I want a better angle to get to this. So I'm going to be like those two little curved strokes. I'm going to do a little curve out, a little curve out, and a bottom stroke. Maybe another one like that there. Okay. I'm just implying. These are just little bits of flowers in the sky. Flowers that you're seeing in the night, and they're so light. But even though it's very dark and a lot of this is in silhouette, you can still see them. That's all that's happening here. And by breaking up these patterns instead of just doing a repetitive pattern, it gives us this feeling of things being more real. All right, so I did one of the five there. Find your cherry blossom. Be easy on yourself. Not doing heart surgery here. And it is, completion is the perfection. Just finish the piece. You can always come back and do another one. You can practice. You know, you're not stuck. So just do something you enjoy. Do a little one here. See, I'm gonna make big sizes and little sizes. Some small ones here. And this little branch, just keeping it mellow. I'm gonna be like, ooh, that. Drop a yellow one there. Here. Couple dabs, 1, 2, 3 dabs. We're dabbing, right? That's all we're doing. We're almost done with this project. Can you believe it? Now I'm gonna come back and add a little bit of yellow. Dab, 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 dab. See, I'm just saying there's some cherry blossoms. You can know about it. Here's one of the five petaled ones. Right, five petal cherry blossom. Another five petaled cherry blossom right there. So now that I've got this all worked out, I'm going to look for some places to put some just random blossom petals floating in the wind, because they do it. Okay. Rinse out my brush. Get your round detail, get your tiny, tiny bright, either will work. Get some yellow and a little white, but mostly just yellow. And where you have five petals showing, you're going to drop a little yellow center. Just where you have the five petals showing. Just where. Okay? Nothing to stop you from doing this project. Nothing. And now, we'll actually have some pins on Pinterest of some denim projects. I suggest if you're gonna release a canvas line, maybe more than string art. It's just a thought, just a feeling that I have, just an idea that you gotta give people a jump point on what to do. They're like, oh, it'd be good for multimedia. What does that even mean? I mean, I know what it means. There it is. Oh my goodness. I'm all talking and we finished. Look at that. We did it. We did it. Come on. That's so crazy, easy, and fun, and something anyone can do, and you can do it. You can have that out today. You can have painted your canvas any solid color. You could have followed along to how to make the denim look on a canvas. You could have gotten denim and painted this. All of these are completely acceptable answers. You know I want you to share with me on Facebook. You know I want you to share with me on Instagram and Twitter and come on Pinterest and help me out. Check out the end cards to let me know what we're doing next. Gotta subscribe because you can't get any more of this goodness. Love to know if y'all think thread bangers like Game of Thrones. You know, it's okay. They won't even notice. Just seriously, they have like millions of people that watch. I'm just one crazy one of them. All right. I'm gonna see you with the easel really soon for another awesome project. For sure, July 17th, you know you wanna check. Hashtag love summer art out. See what everybody does, what the other artists are doing. Bye. Smelly cat, smelly cat. What are they feeding you? Smelly cat. Grumpy cat, where are they tweeting you? La la la, la la la, painting today. La la la, la la la, painting home.